The Philippine Trade Department activates a monitoring team to ensure that the price freeze is being observed in Metro Manila supermarkets and groceries. The DTI ordered the price control on Wednesday to protect consumers from unjust price increases due to Typhoon Karina. The order covers essential goods, including rice, bread, and fresh vegetables, among others. Aboitiz Equity Ventures with flat earnings in the first half of the year. Core net income was at 11.4 billion pesos, up by just 2% from 2023. In the second quarter, this stood at 6.6 billion from the previous 6.5. A silver lining, though, it saw its F&B segment contributing 15 times higher at 2.8 billion pesos from the 181 million year-on-year. This was notably after its joint acquisition with Coca-Cola Euro-Pacific Partners of Coca-Cola Philippines. Next, to Filmvest Hospitality, it signed earlier this week a deal to develop a prime property in Baguio City. FHC previously won the six-year contract from the Basis Conservation and Development Authority and the John Hay Management Corporation. Filmvest is naming the project Hay Diner in its latest venture into the F&B sector. It is seen as a valuable addition to Baguio's vibrant restaurant scene. And finally, PXP Energy trims its losses in the first half. This was down to 9.5 million pesos against the 13.4 million last year. This, among others, is on the higher average crude oil price and higher volume from its Galok mine operations. Petroleum revenue is also up 9% to nearly 43 million pesos. Moving forward, PXP of the MVP Group says it will assess and study other oil and gas projects in the Philippines. A search and rescue mission is underway for a missing crew member of a Philippine-flagged vessel that sank off the waters of Bataan. For more on this, let's bring in our correspondent, Jeff Caparaz. Hi, Jeff. How's the situation?
Hi, Denise. A search and rescue mission is ongoing for a missing crew member of the Philippine-flagged motor tanker which sank off the waters of Limay, Bataan past 1 a.m. today. Philippine Coast Guard was able to rescue 16 of the 17 crew of the tanker Terra Nova, which was carrying 1.4 million liters of oil. It was en route to Iloilo when the incident happened.
Bandang mga alas 10 ng gabi, daramdaman na nila na malakas yung alon. Malakas yung alon at nag-decide yung kapitan na bumalik. Pero initially, nahirapan sila sapagkat ang sabi nila ay pasalubong sila dun sa alon. At ang term ng mga crew ay sumalok sila ng alon at pinasok yung barko hanggang tuluyan sila nag-capsize.
Authorities are still investigating if the bad weather caused the ship to sink. The Coast Guard has monitored an oil spill stretching 2 nautical miles.
Based on our experience from previous oil spill incidents, ang nauuna talaga ay yung working fuel ng barko na lumabas. So very minimal lang yan kasi kung yun ang nag-leak na yung tangke, baka marami na kaagad yan, hindi lang mga 2 nautical miles, no? And hopefully we would be able to contain the fuel na nandun pa sa mga tanks niya. So we are racing against time and we will try to do our best para makontain na kagad at hindi na lumabas yung fuel.
Denise, Marine Environmental Protection personnel have been also mobilized by the PCG to combat the spill. PCG also dispatched personnel to Nabotas, Bulacan, and Pampanga to monitor and prepare for an oil spill. Balilo is warning Manila and its shoreline could be affected if the industrial fuel carried by the tanker spreads. The waters where the tanker sank are within Manila Bay. PCG has coordinated with PDRMO and Governor Bataan for preparations of a possible oil spill. The company who owns the tanker has hired a salvor for salvage operations, the PCG said. Meanwhile, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Thursday ordered the Department of Environmental and Natural Resources, the Department of Science and Technology, and the PCG to assess the environmental impact of the spill. The Philippine leader made the directive during during a situation briefing held at the Presidential Security Command compound shortly after the motor tanker capsized. The president, however, noted that strong winds and high waves are making it hard for the government to contain the oil spill. Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista, meanwhile, said that they have already coordinated with the private sector to deploy their resources as soon as possible. Denise.
Jeff Caparaz with that story. Thanks, Jeff. With the Philippine e-commerce market estimated to reach $24 billion by 2025, more Filipinos are now vulnerable to scams and other fraudulent activities. Tom Tovar, CEO of cybersecurity firm AppDome, says the Philippines is among the world's mobile-first countries, with Filipinos using up to 18 to 20 mobile applications a day. Tovar says around 40% of Filipinos faced some form of scam in the last year. Tovar says more consumers now expect app developers to help keep their online experience safe.
In the early days of the mobile explosion, the responsibility was on the user, sort of buyer beware, to protect themselves. These days, a lot like what you're talking about, the consumer is really looking to the brand, the provider of the application, to deliver the protections that are needed to keep their experience safe. So about 98% of consumers globally say it really is the brand's responsibility not only to protect their privacy and their data and their login, but also protect them from the more advanced threats like malware, fraud, and so forth.